So, hello all. Today I want to show you my version of a digital clock in Minecraft, okay? I made that with the programmable RedNet controller from Minefactory Reloaded. Yeah, let's watch this just for a minute, because I want to prove you guys that this thing is actually working totally correct. Yeah, I'm really proud of this because it's a very tiny construction, especially compared to the vanilla Minecraft things. This blew up my mind. I would advise you to watch my two little short videos on how this 7-segment encoder works in the RedNet controller. I think it would help you if you like to build also one of these. I have made a video for 1 7-segment encoder, and I made a video for 2 7-segment encoder. And Sunset, you won't screw up my moment, won't you? Okay, it's 12 o'clock, 59 minutes 59 seconds and 13. You saw, it's working fine. It's working perfectly. I also tested it. It's absolutely precise. So, how do we build this? Let's see. Well, first of all, you have to do the basic setup, as I mentioned earlier in the other tutorials. Like, this is a smaller display, but it's the same principle. We have this decomposer, internal to decimal, and we have two of these 7-segment encoders. Well, I explained that over here a little better. First things first, the way you do a 7-segment encoder from the backside is, just for showing you, you have these A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Those are the 7 segments on a different colored channel. So you should begin on the left upper corner with the A, then go there, there's the B, here's the C, here's the D, here's the F, and in the middle is the G. So, well, okay, that's a 7-segment encoder. Well, the rest does, as you see, fully automatically. Well, how does this thing work? Okay, this here is our main computer. It is the main clock. It's set to 10 ticks, cause 20 ticks are 1 second, and you have to consider it has 10 ticks on and 10 ticks on off. So all in all, one rising edge, it is called, has 20 ticks in total. So we have this wave square timer with 20 ticks in total. Nevertheless, it's just 10 here, but consider it's 20. Okay, it's important. And we have the counter. We are sending this signal on the various or whatever internal bus to the counter, and the counter is set to 60. So and the value is giving out at the right hand side. Here we have the V, the value. So the value, you can see the current value is in seconds. It's increasing every second. So we have the value like Y and X between 0 and 59. So we'll split that into X and Y. I miss a sign here. Sorry, because for the example we just say it's 25. So it's YX. Just for you to understand that. We split this 25 into a 2 and a 5. So this thing here splits it into X and Y. Okay? Because this is a decomposer, internal decimal, whatever, the value comes from the left side. The value is the second. And now we are splitting it into a right number and a left number, like here, okay? The X is the right number, so it's counting from 0 to 9, and every time when it hits the 9, it triggers the other one to increase by 1, and this one will do up to 6. Okay, so we have the Y. Okay, that's wrong here. And for the example to show you, it's 25. Okay, the 5 is shown by the this 7 segment encoder, and the 2 is shown by this 7 segment encoder. So when we get a value of 25 from here. Okay, I hope this is understandable. Let's just get it through once again. We have the main clock with 20 ticks in total. It gives us the value which is shown here. The value is going into the splitter, I just say the decomposer internal decimal, and this splits the value in separated single numbers from 0 up to 9, and these numbers are shown on the display by these 7 segment encoders. Okay, that's the whole trick. The rest is very easy. Once you understood this little thing here to show two numbers on a two number display, you got all the trick. So next thing with the counter is when it counts to 60, it will set to 0 automatically, and it will emit a signal on our queue. So it's on virus 2, because I just wanted to make sure it will get it, so I just added a pulse lengthener. It's not needed, but I just implemented it. So our pulse, which goes off every 60 seconds, will be emitted on the left side on the white channel, right here. Well, at the moment it's on 0. Yeah, no? It's not really 0. Let's see. Oh, yeah, it's just emitting every second, every minute. So we are at 36 minutes. Okay, I have to hurry up. Yeah. So this counter counts to 60, and then it starts from 0 again. So when it does that, we will get a signal over here just for simulating. Okay, see the signal is coming here every minute. Yeah, every single minute. So in this thing here, we have ignored that on page 2. Also a simple counter, which increases the counter when a signal comes from the right side on the white channel. Again, we have our value on down. This is this one here. Value of minutes. It's at 8 or something, between 0 and 59. This value again goes into the splitter. I explained this there. That setup here is exactly the same as there. Just but the difference that these are the minutes and those are the seconds. This thing here is the important part. So again, it increases when from the right side comes the signal, and also it counts up to 60, because we have 60 minutes in 1 hour. Okay, 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in a 1 hour. So it also emits a signal to our counter. Okay. Yeah, joke. So again, we have a counter which counts to 24, because we will only have 24 hours per day, and it increments increases the counter if from the right side again comes a signal on the white channel. And we also surely have the value output on the downside here, and it's a value between 0 and 23.